And good looking too. It's really nice. Although, Jay's a great guy and I enjoy Jay's company. He quit drinking like last year or something. He looks great. He dropped like 30 pounds or something.
Quit drinking yet continuing to work at the bar.
Right.
Sam Malone.
I know a couple other guys too, a guy at Cinnabar. And then I know some bar patrons who don't drink also but still come in.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Yeah, Steven.
Is that good on them?
Yeah, Steven, who used to work at the Caravan. And he was a TV, radio, film, theater student who I helped, you know, way back when. And, he quit. It's been a few years now, actually. He still smokes weed, though. Yeah, most of these reformed drinkers still smoke weed.
Oh, and they smoke cigarettes like a frickin' chimney, man.
Right, yeah. It's like the only thing they got left, you know.
Yeah, no, I get it. Oh, well, one thing to keep in mind, I have started I love it, my friend Matt described it as nihilistic.
Mm.
Well, I have this dash cam, and it records all of my drives,
mm-hmm.
and they're just boring as heck, and for a while I was burning them to DVDs, and I'm just somebody who hates to destroy video. Once video's created, like, it needs to be saved and kept and preserved, but who cares about, you know, boring dash cam videos where nothing happens?
Right.
Well, about 2 weeks ago, I had a brilliant idea. YouTube will host as much pointless video as I possibly want. So I now have my own YouTube channel, Commute TV, where I have just hours and hours and hours and hours and hours of nothing but my boring dash cam videos of all of my drives. So, this will be posted to YouTube by tomorrow. Just be cautious because you're being recorded.
Why do you record your drives? I'm not seeing what's the point?
Well, partially because I want to document my life, and if I could record every single moment of it,
what's up?
Okay, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
So that's one thing.
Mm-hmm.
But the other is, I just got this dash cam for free. It was this offer. It's a new age dash cam where it's tied in with your phone, and it's connected to other cams. It's weird. Like, if you put on a hard brake, it automatically uploads the last minute of your drive to the cloud in case there's an accident.
Right.
You can use it for insurance purposes.
Bird.
Oh, okay. I usually get off at race.
But. Well, you could do that, but then you're backtracking.
All right, so I'm getting off bird. Okay.
And then you're going to go left at the bottom of the ramp.
All right. So, yeah, you know, basically people will simply record it, and then if nothing exciting happens, they just record over it.
Right.
And I decided I'm going to post all of it to YouTube. So, right now, you can go and see my commute from yesterday morning if you want to.
Well, you know, there was this, sometime in the last year, one of the highest rated television programs in Norway was simply a stationary shot of this train in Norway. just that was it. It's just this train. And it goes through these real scenic, you know, fjords and all that kind of thing.
Yeah.
But it was like 12 hours long or something, and it got really high ratings and people were watching it. So maybe you'll develop some fans in Norway or something.
Yeah, well, I'm hoping. You know, it's like a video of a bird in Yule Log or something.
Yeah, right, exactly.
Yeah. Yeah, I was just like, why should I store all this pointless video? But it's like, when will YouTube... I don't get their business... I guess I get their business model, but literally, because I posted my hour and 13-minute commute yesterday, they're now going to have that available for until the end of time. You know, they're going to pay to sustain that thing for...
Pretty funny.
And, you know, I don't have... I only have one subscriber, and that's my son, Zane. And, of course, I don't advertise it in any way, shape, or form, but I do have a few, you know, videos that have, like, 8 or 9 views. Like, okay. That doesn't mean, you know, they watch them from beginning to end, but...
Yeah.
But it is interesting because there have been a few times where I've been like on phone calls with people, and so I've had to go and review the phone calls, make sure we weren't talking about anything sensitive. So far, I don't think we've talked about anything other than the fact that we're being recorded.
Today, you mean?
Yeah, in this car.
Not in the car, no.
All right. So there's no reason I should be hesitant to post this. So I'll hang a right?
Yeah. And then you can... There might be a space in the front, or you could use the back parking lot.
Yeah.
It's good that he's got that nice big lot back there. That really helps.
Is that a spot right there, or is that timed?
There's the driveway.
I see. How about that right there?
I don't know. I think it might be a temporary, like a green curb or
minutes,
something.
Yeah.
Yes.
Assuming we've actually got. Yeah, there's one right there.
Oh,
is that not handicap?
I don't think so.
Yeah,
I think the sign is just about the lot in general, I think.
Oh yeah, that's not a handicap sign. It does say something about disabilities. That is about disabilities.
It is.
But this doesn't, you know, there's a spot over there, right?
Yeah.
I'm just going to repark it. I'll meet.
Ah.